Assalamu alaikum grade 10 students. Today we are going to start our first chapter of Park Study, and the first chapter of Park Study is about History Period of Pakistan 2. In this chapter we will study about Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto government from 1971 to 77, Ziaul Haq government 1977 to 88, Mohammad Khan Junejo government 1958 to 88, Restoration of Democracy 1988 to 99, Nuclear Test and Pervez Musharraf government from 1999 to 2008. So here is our first topic, which is about Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto government from 1971 to 77. First of all, on 16 December 1971, Dhaka fell to enemies due to the internal strife and direct military intervention of India. Before going to start my further lecture, first of all you have to open the grade 10 book, then play my video to make sure you understand my lecture well. And these are only the main headings of our chapter number 1, topic number 1. Further subheadings I will explain in my lecture. So, on 16 December 1971, Dhaka fell to enemies due to internal strife and intervention of Indian Army. East Pakistan was separated from West Pakistan and emerged as Bangladesh. General Yahya Khan resigned after his defeat and on 20th December 1971 transferred his power to Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto as Chief Martial Law Administrator. At that time Bhutto was Foreign Minister of the country. Bhutto made many changes in the government and tried to uplift the economy and the positive image of Pakistan. After taking over the government, Bhutto made some administrative changes. He forced the army chief to resign and replace him with General Tikka Khan as a new commander-in-chief. Bhutto strengthened relations with all Muslim countries and international community. One of his achievements was signing the Simla Agreement with India. According to the agreement, India released all prisoners of war in April 1972. He left it martial law and restored democracy. One of his achievements is about the recommendations for forming a new constitution for a country, which comes in economic reforms. Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto introduced the following economic reforms, which are: the limit for the profession of land was reduced from 500 acres to 150 acres of canal irrigated land, and from 1000 acres to 300 acres of rain fed land. The second objective, which is presented as economic reform of agriculture, especially agriculture reforms, was that tenant would have haqqe shifaz in case the land they cultivate is sold by its owner. Means if the owner of the land sold its land, he will get tenant's haqqe shifa. No one could evade the tenants, but only when the share of produced has not been paid to the landlord. Fourth, the owner shall be responsible for the supply of seeds, payment of the land revenue and irrigation water charges. The land exceeding the prescribed limits shall be confiscated from the landlords and will be divided among the tenants free of cost. A civil servant during his service or after retirement can possess only 100 acres of land. The state agricultural lands shall be divided among the landless farmers. Means these were the economic reforms in terms of agricultural reforms which is made by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto when he came into the government. And he passed this agricultural reforms ordinance in 1st March 1972. On the second half, there is reforms for industrial workers. So, the reforms of industrial workers are especially court, labor courts were set up to protect the rights of the industrial workers. 5% shares of the labor in the total profit of the industry was made obligatory as bonus. Medical facilities for industrial workers was made obligatory. Group insurance and the social security system were introduced. The owner of big enterprises were bound to bear the educational expenses of at least one child of every labor up to matric level. The other thing which is Zulfikar Ali Bhutto done on 11 May 1972 was a devaluation of rupee. The Bhutto government devalued Pakistani rupee against the exchange rates of foreign currencies, especially the US dollar. The purpose was to encourage exports. After that, there is other heading is nationalization policy. On January 2, 1972, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto with an ordinance, passed an ordinance and announced the policy of taking big industrial units under state control. The policy aimed at protecting the public interest as well as it induced negative results. Due to mismanagement of government employees and labor unions, the nationalized industries suffered heavy losses and their production reduced considerably. After that, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto also nationalized the insurance companies. The government nationalized all the insurance companies and merged them into the State Life Insurance Corporation. The corporation was further divided into various groups with a view of create competition among them. Nationalization of banks. On 1st January 1974, Zulfikar Ali passed another ordinance about the banks, in which he nationalized all the banks under the State Bank of Pakistan. This let the government have effective control over the flow of capital, but performance of the bank declined due to the non-cooperative activities. Educational reforms. After that, the third reform that Zulfikar Ali Bhutto done was educational reforms. Zulfikar Ali announced his educational policy on 15 March 1972. Beginning of 1st October 1972 and 1st October 1974, education will be provided free of cost up to 8 and 10, level 8 to 10 respectively. This ordinance was passed by Zulfikar Ali Bhutto that every child should get free cost of education till level 8 and 10 respectively. All private schools and colleges were nationalized. It was cleared that no appointment shall be made in these institutions unless approved by the government. For welfare of the students, stipends and interest-free loans shall be provided to them. These were the objectives which is passed in Zulfikar Ali Bhutto's reform, educational reforms in 1972 and in 1974. Now the last heading is impact of Bhutto's government reforms. Means what was the impact of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto reforms? So the impact of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto reforms are that standard education suffered a lot as a result of nationalization of educational institution. Due to lack of discipline in this institution, the students got involved in practical politics, which badly affected the educational environment, as well as the industrial reforms created tussles between the industrialized and the laborers. Due to nationalization of industrial units, production declined. As a result, the industrialist met losses and started shutting down the factories, which affected Pakistan's foreign trade very badly. So that was all about the first topic of Zulfikar Ali Bhutto and its reforms. The other main thing is Constitution of 1973. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto passed on 17 April 1972, the National Assembly formed a constitution committee comprising 25 members who were selected from all the political parties in the parliament on February 2, 1973 to form a constitution for Pakistan. Chaudhry Fazal Ilahi was elected as a president, and under this constitution and Zulfikar Ali Bhutto swam in as the prime minister of Pakistan. Following were the silent features of 1973 constitution. First of all, written constitution. The constitution of 1973 was in the written form, which comprises 280 articles. Second was Islamic provision. The objective resolution, which was passed by the first Legislative Assembly of Pakistan in March 1949, according to that state shall be exercise the authority through democratically elected representative, and the resolution proclaims that absolute sovereignty, which means in Urdu yaktaniyat, entirely universe belongs to Almighty Allah alone, means the sovereignty, the create, the oneness of this whole universe is only belongs to Almighty Allah. Third, parliamentary system of government. In Constitution of 1973, they introduced the parliamentary system of government, in which the National Assembly elects the Prime Minister, who is chief executive of the country and accountable to the National Assembly. Fourth one, Federal Constitution. The Constitution makes Pakistan a federal republic. The formula of power sharing between the Federation and provinces is well defined. Free Judiciary. The Constitution secures the independence of judiciary. The sixth one, Rule of Law. All citizens of Pakistan are made accountable before the law, irrespective of their ethnicity, language and designation, etc. The seventh one was fundamental rights. Means the constitution ensures the fundamental rights to all the Pakistani citizens, irrespective of their religion, their authenticity, ethnicity, etc., creed, color, everything. The constitution also guaranteed the rights of the minorities. Minority, the religious which comes in minority are Christians, Hindu, Sikhs and Parsis. National language. Urdu is declared as Pakistan's national language. It provided that necessary steps shall be taken to make Urdu the official language of the country. This was done in 1973 constitution. It is stated that Urdu should be done the should be used as official language of the country within the next 15 days, and English shall be continued as the official language. Till then, the time of 15 years, English will be remain as the official language. But in 15 years, Urdu should be replaced English as a official language. High treason. The Constitution articulates that whosoever abrogates the Constitution by unconstitutional means or attempts to do so shall be guilty of high treason. Means anybody who goes opposite of this constitution will be guilty of high treason. High treason, treason means baghi, ghaddar. Matlab ki jo bhi shakhs is constitution se articulate karega, is usse se aur ke hat ke hatega, usse kya kaha jayega ki sabse bada ghaddar tasavvur kiya jayega. So that was all about 1973 constitution. I will explain the national language as well again. Urdu declared as a Pakistan national language in 1973 constitution, and it is necessary, and it provides necessary steps shall be taken to make Urdu the official language of the country within the next 15 years. Till then means till 15 years, English will remain as the official language, but after 15 years, Urdu will be replaced as the official language in Pakistan. So that was all about Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto government from 1971 to 77. I will further explain the next topic in my next video, because this video is went very long. So if you have any question, or if you want to ask anything, or if you have any confusion, you can ask me in the Google Classroom in the comment section, and I will reply over there. So stay home, stay safe, pray for everyone. Thank you very much.